don't spell.
Now, we've had some issues before in the past, so today we're going to put our hands in. On three, we're going to say no technical difficulties on three.
I'm coming.
All in. No technical difficulties on three. One, two, three. No technical difficulties. Yeah.
I was about to say on three.
You guys ready for this?
Sure. Yeah, sure.
Yeah? All right, good. All right, welcome back to... Jeez! No! Stop it! Welcome to the Sting Podcast. We want to thank you for tuning in, and it's another exciting week. We've got three, not one, not two, but three guests. And before I introduce who these guests are, I'm actually going to play something, a little clip from some of the work that they've done with me in the past. So listeners, if you hear this, you're probably going to recognize these people. So I'm going to start with this particular one. First clip, I'm going to put in the middle, and hopefully, I know this is a YouTube clip, but we're going to put the sound right up there so we can see it, and this is for them to actually hear it. Okay, here we go.
For this week's Spotlight Minute, Alan got the chance to catch up with our new long-term substitute teacher, Aloise Carrasco. Alan.
Whoa!
Yeah!
Whoa! Are you ready to be interviewed?
Sure.
All right, let's get it started.
There's guest number one.
Hey, guys.
We kind of already got the name. And then guest number two. Hold on a sec. I got it loaded up here. Here we go. The beginning of this is going to get, oh, my God. This one is going to get super loud. So audience members, please, if you have headphones on, make sure you brace your ears for this.
No! No! Ah! Ah! Ah!
There's the news.
Now that second clip was every Halloween. We still do it traditionally. I always want to do something fun on Halloween, and this was from The Shining. I know they probably weren't even familiar with the movie, but there's a part in the movie where, you know, Jack breaks through a door with an axe. She, if you could see it, she's got a, what do you have?
I just have a broom.
I think you had like a spatula, and I said, I'm going to tell you who it is in a sec, but I said, scream like you really mean it. And she screamed, and this, mind you, this is during the school day. So there's a class next to us, and it is like the teacher came over and said, "Is everything okay in here?" Yeah, it was right. So I'm like, "Yeah, no, it's fine. It's just for a bit." So it was pretty hilarious. But anyway, without further ado, let me introduce the guests. If you haven't already guessed who they are, to my left we have Flor Panagos. Did I say it right?
Yeah.
Flor. We have Dominic Wood.
Yeah. What's up?
And we have. Move in a little closer. You guys are going to remember this guy. We have Alan Alcala.
Hey, guys.
So these guys, the idea of this show is that we wanted to bring these guys in. We wanted to, especially for eighth graders, we wanted to make you guys kind of feel comfortable as you make that transition to from eighth grade to, you know, to high school. So I said, who better to talk about coming and talk about high school? The three great kids that I've had in the past. And in fact, I've known you guys for what? I would say at school, 5 years, right?
Maybe, yeah. Something like that, maybe, yeah.
Yeah.
Probably
yeah,
longer.
Somewhere around.
You were probably fourth grade. So, I mean, and then I've known them, you know, in high school, and I was pleasantly surprised to see them when they did their our pep rally a few weeks back.
Yeah.
And two of you, were you there too?
I don't think so, no.
So I saw, and then I like noticed like someone's directing the whole band, right? Yeah. It was Flor. It was crazy, and it was good to see Dominic. You play what instrument? Tuba?
I play the euphonium.
Euphonium
or baritone?
What is that?
It's like probably the best way I can explain it. It's like a tuba. It's like a
that's what
miniature
I thought.
Tuba, and it sounds like a French horn. It's in the range of like a trombone.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's a
it's a marching baritone.
Yeah, it's a marching baritone.
So I decided to ask these guys to come on in, talk about high school, and luckily I was able to book them all. And you know how great is it they were able to sacrifice a Friday afternoon night. Like, come on, how many students are going to come in on a Friday afternoon after a long day or a long week? these guys did it. So I'm going to have we try to keep some structure to this show. First of all, before we start, what do you guys think of the studio?
It looks really good.
Would you mind describing it? Because we've never described it to our listeners. What would you?
So on the ceiling, there's like a big dragon, right? Okay. He's looking down at us.
Stop. Stop.
Okay. Actually, though, on the wall I'm facing right now, it's like a big green screen, which I guess you guys use for the news, right?
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. And then surrounding is these black foam walls with lights on them, you know? And then there's also this TV over here. I was like, the Sting podcast logo or
professional
something. Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, exactly. Professional. We designed that.
Wow. That's cool.
Yeah, not bad, right? And we got nice mic set up and everything. So guests, think about coming in. We've got a great setup. Mm. All right, I'm gonna start. We try to keep some structure, so I'm gonna start, and then these eighth grade girls have some great questions to ask you. And we want you to be honest. We're all about honesty, so please be blunt, be to the point. But if they have follow-up questions, they will definitely be asking you those. All right, guys. So to start, I want you to kind of go back to your former self in eighth grade. So you got to think back what for you. By the way, Alan, sophomore. Mm-hmm. So he's a couple of years removed. Dominic and Floor, both juniors. So they're a few years removed. So I want you to kind of go back and from eighth grade and just maybe the second half of the year where you started to think, oh my God, I'm going to high school next year. It's happening. I want you to think about any anxiety. I'm not saying you had to be necessarily nervous about it, but I'm sure, I mean, I did. I mean, 150 years ago when I went to high school, I remember an eighth grader coming in and, high schooler who was just a year ahead of us would come. He came in the last week of school and talked to us about high school. And I felt a lot better because he made me I was really nervous. I had no idea what to expect. So I want you to think back when you guys were eighth graders and what were some of the kind of things that you were looking forward to and what were you kind of anxious about? Flora, why don't we start with you?
Some things that I looked forward to in high school was definitely the more variety of clubs and sports and experiences that you could do, because here in elementary school it's to a low level, not but it's to a certain extent. But in high school you could expand on anything you want, and in classes in art class or in music you could grow your knowledge if you really want to go into a certain field.
Pursue
they
it,
help
yeah.
you in everything.
That's awesome. Dominic?
I know I'm going to sound kind of an old man, but in eighth grade, I was online because of the you know what.
Oh, of course.
So, and going into high school, it was number one, I was going to go back in person. So I kind of didn't know what to expect because I kind of grew accustomed to, doing
online.
School from my bed, maybe eating some pizza rolls.
Sure.
So I was concerned about making that jump. But for most of these eighth graders, you don't need to worry about that because now you're already in person, so you can go like that. So another thing I was worried about academically speaking,
yeah,
because number one, you're dealing with six, seven classes in a single day, and you got to manage all of those classes. So that thing particularly scared me.
Sure.
Walking into high school.
Yeah, I know the girls have some questions about that too. Yeah. Alan, what were you most anticipating, anxious about?
Honestly, Floor said, all the new classes would be cool, like French, and I'm actually taking French right now.
Cool.
Yeah, those stuff would be pretty.
Are you planning on living in France? I mean, why? Oh, my wife took French, and I'm why did you take French in high school? You live in Arizona.
I just think that French would be more interesting to take in Spanish, because I already kind of know Spanish.
Oh, that's true.
You know? Mm-hmm. It'd be kind of redundant.
Trilingual.
If I took Spanish again, it would just kind of feel like an afterthought, But anyways, I got a little off topic, but yeah. So like Flo said, the new classes are cool, to have new opportunities, new clubs, it's a big thing. High school is a big thing, That's why they made a whole musical about it. That's the whole
true.
Reason.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah. Good point. But you were open and happy pretty much anytime I ever saw you. So you probably weren't really too nervous about high school.
No, honestly, the only thing I was more worried and sad about was Coyote shutting down, man.
Yeah.
That's tough.
Well, it's tough for our students, but you know what? They made the transition, and I got lucky because I wanted to, this is the school, and I knew once we were going to close, I talked to the principal here. I'm like, can you get me back in here? I need to, this is where I've been before. So it didn't take him what, like maybe a month or two. And all the kids just kind of really, they kind of got really used to it really quickly. So, I mean, it wasn't much of a problem, but yeah, it's tough. I mean, it's tough, especially if you started in kinder there and you were there a little time, but you know, kids are flexible. They're resilient and, you know, they've made the change pretty positively.
That's good.
All right. Moving on for me still, before we get to the girls, we want our kids to have continued success going into high school. What are some things that our eighth graders can be doing like right now to get ready for it? Let's start with you, Dominic.
Well, first off, I think it's kind of important to start kind of thinking about what path do you necessarily want to go on? Like, because there's a lot of different fields, and like both Flora and Alan said, there's a lot of opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
Like you could specialize in whatever. So I think it's important to start thinking about, you know, what like intrigues you, like, so that way you could kind of start making that plan. Like, do you want to go into engineering? Do you want to go into medicine or all that? But more from like a general standpoint, start thinking about building good academic habits, especially like, that was probably my biggest issue for me.
Time management.
Time management is a really good skill to work on. Thinking about good ways to study, especially for like exams. Like I know we have the ACT coming up in a couple months.
Sure.
So you got to be able to kind of like figure out good ways to study. And in turn, by doing that while still in middle school, you're able to kind of set yourself up. It's still going to be a radical change,
sure,
but you're at least going to be kind of more.
Like, so you're not so overwhelmed when you go from eighth to that.
Exactly.
Because there is, it is a jump, right? Because a lot of the kids are like, oh no, high school's easy. It's going to be an easy.
Oh, it's
not
a jump.
Yeah, it's a jump. All right, Alan, what about you?
Oh, honestly, I might sound a little contradictory here, but just don't sweat it. You know, just like, don't sweat high school as much as like you think it should, you know, like. Like, obviously, yeah, it's a big deal. Like I said earlier, like, that's why I mean when I say I might sound contradictory, but like, you know, just like, don't worry about it too much. You know, like you'll like, if you know that you'll do just fine, then I think you will do just fine. You know, also get ready to like adjust to new stuff too, because like I tell you what, as a freshman, going from Coyote Ridge to Independence High School, like structure wise, was the biggest difference ever, dude. Like,
in what way?
Like you know, Coyote, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like each like building had a few rooms in it, and you just go to like each building whenever you need to go to like next class, right? Mm-hmm. Like art class, that different stuff. Yeah, with Independence, like it's just like ignoring science building for now. There's just one big building with everything in it, so it's just like sort of like taking the first week, maybe even the first 2 weeks, like just remembering your layout. Where all the rooms are, what like red 27, like red, like just the red, blue, gray system itself, like that was like a crazy game changer for me. But like I said, this is ignoring the science room. There's a whole, building. There's a whole other building for science. I'm not even kidding.
You figure with technology that we would have like your school mapped out and we could just navigate to it. Maybe, Wouldn't that be kind of nice if we just on our phones? Like someone needs to create that.
One of these days.
Yeah.
The coding class will take care of it. Right. Don't worry about it. Yeah.
And Flora, any advice for these eighth graders that soon to be high schoolers?
I definitely think, because personally, when I went through, I was sweating. I was so scared for my life. And then what Alan said with like the platform, like the school layout, there's like four to five buildings that we have at Independence. So it's definitely hard. And I know like other schools, it's also hard because there's multiple buildings. So it's basically here where you have to go to like, what's your class called?
My class? Yeah. Well, it's media literacy, but I call it computers and technology.
Okay. So like, you know how sometimes kids take that class or take band and they have to go like to different paths. It's like exactly the same thing. But what Dominic was saying about like academics, I definitely say try to build good habits, because you're going to need it if you're going to take honors and AP classes, because it's very hard if you just procrastinate all the time. So I say stick with it. Try to, at least if you're going to procrastinate, do majority of the work, lay off a little bit, and then do like the rest of the week.
Yeah, and I always try to tell students, I'm like, look, you can't procrastinate, like you said, because I used to do that all the time. I did it all through high school. Finally, I figured it out. Just do a little bit each day. Like, try not to wait, because it would stress me out more not to have something done. I feel really good about myself when I have something done. Like, then I can kind of relax and work on other things. So yeah, I would definitely say time management is going to be huge. Good answers. Good tips. All right. Another one for me, and then we'll let the girls kind of take a rip at you guys. All right. You guys are currently juniors, and Alan, you're a sophomore, correct? Mm-hmm. All right. Would you mind explaining, we'll start with you, Alan. Would you mind explaining the importance of maintaining good grades throughout high school? And I'm going to share like why we basically threatened our daughter to maintain good grades, but I'll let you go first, Alan.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, it is pretty important to keep good grades in high school, you know. Like, also just like not even from an educational standpoint, just like it's a cool thing, you know, cool feeling to look at your student view report card and see it's all good, you know, you don't have anything missing, everything's looking good, you know. Also, because like think about it this way, you know, if you have a lot of percentage in a class, you know, even if you do take a hit from an assignment you didn't do so good on, you still have like some percentage left over for, right, to like try to cover that up for, you know. Like, so it's not as detrimental if you have like a – wait, you guys use number system at Discovery,
yeah, we
right?
still have the one first system.
Dude, I miss the number system. I honestly don't like the letters. So A, B, C, D, E.
But like, do they do based on percentages?
Yeah, they do. Yeah,
I kind of like that. I don't know. It just seems a little more exact for me. There's too much gray area with the 1-4 scale, but that's just me.
Yeah, but like I was saying, though, just like keep your grades up, you know. If you make a mistake, it won't be as big as a deal as if you're like an F, like – 55% or something, sure. And you get a bad grade, and like that's just bad, you know. But if you have like a high A, high B, get like a C on an assignment or something, that's not the end of the world, you know. So yeah, just like keep yourself in check, keep your grades up.
Got it.
And do good.
Just all right, our upperclassmen, by the way, for those of you who don't know what that means, is junior and senior year. We got two upperclassmen. They're gonna start thinking about the importance of grades. Dominic, what say you?
At least, like, this kind of pertains to me, but, like, if your plan after high school is to go to college, grade, especially if you want to go to, like, your Harvards, your Dartmouths, your Browns, all those schools, you're going to need to stay on top of your academics, especially. Maintaining good grades is, like, the key to all that. But even if you're not like me and want to go to a college, being able to have, like, showing that you have good grades shows your ability to kind of work hard. And most jobs, they're not going to want someone who is relatively lazy. Like, a D is going to reflect relatively
bad work ethics, right?
Yeah, it's going to reflect kind of poorly on you.
Sure.
So I think that maintaining good grades shows kind of like that skill, but not just like a work ethic, like, but like, you know, your intellectual vitality, to some extent, even your character.
Mm-hmm.
So I think good grades
totally agree.
A lot of part in that.
Good answer. Floor?
With good grades and independence, you get like rewards. Your first semester, you get to go into any like fall, summer sport, whatever, for free. Like, you don't have to pay for the commission. And you get like a lot of benefits. I believe they do like parties for people who have like straight A's, and it helps you be like top 1%.
They still do that in high school?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. And so if you also want to like be valedictorian, it's amazing to have your grades full A's. But at the same time, you don't have to get straight A's. I say B's and A's are really great place. So like, if you don't get an A, like, don't stress about it because it's like not the end of the world.
Right.
And if you get a C, you can definitely make it up over the summer. Just talk to your counselor. The most important thing is just talking to like people, like staff members, because they will definitely be there all the time.
I also have a point that I feel like I should bring up. Just know that, like, because I know I'm very, very guilty of this. Never let your grades define who you are, because like I feel like the meaning that we attach, especially to like D's and F's, it honestly, like, at least for me, when I got I got a really low grade in an AP class, and I reflected on myself so horribly, it's not a great feeling.
No.
But does that one single letter, a letter that you can find in the thing of Campbell soup, don't let that letter define your worth, who you are, because, you know, one single letter isn't going to just show your character.
Right. It's not your complete. I mean, it's not the complete you. We don't know the situation. Maybe you tried your hardest and you're still struggling. I mean, everyone needs a chance to kind of redeem themselves. I totally get what you mean, because a lot of people do. A lot of people do. So that's good advice, because a lot of people going into high school that are listening are probably thinking, I got to do really well. I got to do really well at all costs. Well, you know, your health comes first. So, mm-hmm. I mean, if you're totally stressing yourself out, you're not going to find success. Like Alan said, you want to kind of keep like chill, right, Alan? Chill. You want to kind of keep confident. You want to use your work ethics to kind of keep up with the work, but not to kill yourself over it. You know?
Oh yeah. Do you guys want the headphones, by the way? I feel like I've been using it for a while now.
Anyone want to hear their voice? It's kind of cool.
I
want to
try.
I like to be able to hear like you guys.
Whoa.
Yeah, right? Hello. You didn't think I sounded this good, did you, Flora?
Okay.
All right. Quick question before we pivot to the girls and their questions. They have a lot for you. College. Are you thinking about college?
Yeah.
College?
Mm-hmm.
College.
Ditto.
All right, so we're all thinking about college. So I, like, going back to what I referenced before, like my daughter went to school, high school, and we just said, look, we didn't pressure her, you know, kind of like Dominic said, we don't want, but we made it very, like, it was very important for her to do well and keep her grades up, because we knew going in that the plan was college. So mm-hmm. we knew that we would love for her to do well because of money. You know, because, you know, hey, teachers don't make a ton of money. If you can get any kind of help for college, that's just a bonus. Mm-hmm. You know, so I didn't want to stress out. That's one of our stresses with, okay, college is not cheap. I don't know if you guys have looked into it, but it's very, very expensive. So she was planning on going to Flagstaff and going to NAU, and she's there, and she's a junior, and she's got one more year, and she's going to be a teacher, which is crazy, right? Isn't that crazy?
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, pretty cool.
Yeah.
But we told her, hey, maintain those grades because it'll pay off. And sure enough, like Dominic said, not all A's, but she maintained her B or above. I think she got high B's, but she ended up getting, like, I think the presidential, whatever they call it. Oh. It's like the full ride. So it was like, I mean, it saved us a ton of money. I mean, it's still, we pay for dues and other things like that, books and what have you, but it just made such a big difference. So, I mean, listeners, if you guys are planning on college, but please, please focus, do the best you can, maintain those grades, because it definitely pays off, and apply for any kind of grant, right?
Oh,
you guys
yes.
are probably learning a little bit about that.
Scholarships,
the money is out there. You just have to kind of seek it. And, you know, using the internet, it's pretty easy to do these days, Dominic.
And also to bring up a point, like, I know college and the high prices intimidate people, but one thing that I found myself learning was you don't always have to pay the full price, because schools, I think Harvard's one of these schools, they offer financial aid based mm-hmm. on your income, and
right.
you can also look up your financial aid based on, you can also do FAFSA. And that grants financial aid. So the money's out there.
What's FAFSA?
It's like... Oh, wait.
Okay, it's for seniors, so don't apply if you're a junior or lower. It's for seniors to help them get like more like grants for their colleges.
Grants,
like
yeah.
it's another support system from the government to help them go to college and
apply
for college.
So there's options, guys. I mean, what we're saying, I mean, grades are one thing, but there's still options even if you don't have that. Yeah, and
some
I got a question.
I'm actually an art club.
I mean, obviously, I've known these guys for doing the announcements for me for years and playing along with my many gags. So I was hoping, like, to tell some of the students we have now, and then I'm hoping that there's an outlet for them in high school where they could actually kind of pursue, like, either podcasting or, you know, news production.
Yeah.
Are there those kind of things? Let's be honest though, our newscast was pretty good.
Oh, yeah,
it's better than high school.
Coyotes,
is it true?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. Yeah, Coyotes news is on top.
Yeah, oh,
top
thanks, man.
The, whatever
so.
The well,
it's, not, it's not Coyote news anymore.
Yeah,
it's Discovery. News.
I call it Sika news.
Discovery announcements. Yeah, they're even better.
It's the Sika news.
Okay. Yeah,
just say you don't like.
So before we pivot to the girls, actually, no, we're gonna pivot to the girls right now. So I'm gonna kind of we're gonna start with Jody. So Jody, would you mind kind of scooting in here, and I'll move myself. So they have some questions, and guys, and again, since there's three of them, so they're not talking over each other, why don't you just kind of call them up by name, make it a little bit smoother?
I only know that one's
Alan.
I forgot those two.
Dominic. Floor. Let's a quiz time.
Alan, Floor, Dominic.
Wow.
And speak up.
A+.
They're fast learners.
Okay, so Dominic, you were talking about all of you were talking about it. But I wanted to know, is it difficult to keep up with homework while doing sports and clubs?
Well, for Flora and I, we both do high school band. So I would probably say to some extent, yeah. But I know that there's a lot of people who are much smarter and more gifted than me, but they're able to balance that. But I would probably argue that, it's manageable. Don't let that discourage you from doing it. It's manageable, but you're going to need to put in the work. And it also really comes down to what classes you take. Speaking for myself, my Calc BC class, we literally do nothing. And in my A-Push class, we do the exact opposite. It's a lot of work. So it really comes down to a lot of different factors. But when I say it's manageable, it is manageable. And Flora can also add on to that.
Yeah, I definitely agree because the beginning of this semester, I did marching band, which is every Tuesday night from 5:30 to 8:30. And then Fridays, we have football games, sometimes on Thursdays. And then Saturdays, we have to report at 6 a.m. all the way till 11 p.m. Because of competitions. And so it's definitely hard because our time is limited. And we have 0 hour, which is a whole hour early before school starts. And then I was also part of the badminton team, which was every Tuesdays and Thursdays. Yeah. So I had colliding events. And then I had AP classes with work that had to be due every single day. So it's definitely hard. But if you just give yourself 30 minutes each day to do something, a piece of your classes, then it's definitely easy to do. And you have some kind of motivation. So if you have a sport, you're going to have motivation to keep your grade up in order to play.
Good answer. Jody, why don't you ask it? Let's have Alan start this one. Here, this is you. Take it over. It's you.
I know. Okay. Alan, how hard is it to maintain A's and B's throughout each year?
Honestly... for me personally, it's not that tricky.
Oh, you're such a show-off.
Oh, come on, Mr. Sika. No, but actually though, as long as you just do your work, stay on top of it, you're good. That's it. That's the secret. That's the code. That's the done dealio. You know, just stay on top of your work. The only time that I have missing work is in math, because I never quite know when we have to turn our assignments for math. But my math teacher is cool. Mr. Hampton. You guys ever had Mr. Hampton?
A2 honors?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, Mr. Hampton's a cool guy. He lets you turn in the work late, and he'll give you points for it and stuff. Yeah, ooh. Mr. Hampton, he's a cool guy. But yeah, honestly, just stay on top of your work. Just do it when you need to do it. Don't procrastinate like we were talking about earlier and stuff like that. That's it. That's the code. That's the secret.
All right, Abigail, I know you have a couple questions. Why don't we go?
Three.
She's got three.
Oh, yeah, crazy. Okay. I just wanted to know if high school teachers are strict. Some high school teachers are strict. So if you're gonna go into freshman year, if you have Mr. Gaspar, because he's the honors teacher for English, he's strict on getting your work done, but he's really if you talk to him, he's a really great guy, and he's gonna understand if you have any setbacks, any technological setbacks or anything like that. So some teachers are really strict, hey, you need to do this, you need to do that, and sometimes they will yell and be hey, you're not putting up your work like everybody else is, what are you doing? But at the same time, don't be afraid of them, because they're also a teacher trying to make sure that you succeed in high school. Right. They're just trying to motivate you or light a fire underneath you in order to make you do your stuff.
I like that. That's what I was hoping you'd say, because I think that's what they know. You're going to be a young adult. You are a young adult, but you're going to be an adult very soon, which is scary. I mean, what are you guys, 17?
Yeah.
17.
Oh, my God.
About to be 18.
Wow, that's so crazy.
September.
Crazy.
I get to vote.
Do freshmen get study hall in between their work or classes?
What's study hall?
Like a like free period?
You get lunch. You get lunch. Also, there's also the pace lab too.
Oh, okay.
You can go after school, before school to do work in there. Yeah. So there's that. They do like punch card events too sometimes. If you fill out your punch card, you get like a free like meal from Cane's or something. I don't know.
But but there's not like built-in study halls throughout the day.
Not necessarily, no.
That's a myth. Yeah, we used to have them.
Yeah. Lunchtime.
I used to go to PE, but
lunchtime really is essentially depends,
but okay. Freshman year.
Okay, here's the thing. For Link Crew, we're trying to start another thing in order to I'm part of Link Crew. I'm the vice president. Just like, yeah. Link Crew is a program to help freshmen feel more welcome to independence. And we're trying to build in like an hour for them. They can do homework during their PE class. So it's, I believe it's mandatory for them to join.
What's it
do
like
it.
A freshman boot camp?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Freshman boot camp. Essentially, it's just to get their work done if they need it. It's just an extra hour. It's just for freshmen though. So other classes, I'm sorry.
Do it that way.
Okay. Do teachers exaggerate when they say high school will be miserably harder?
Whoa.
Who said that? Wait. Yeah, Mr.
I don't think he used those words. Miserably harder? Come on now.
You fixed my grammar. You fixed it.
That doesn't say. You're in eighth grade. Girls, guys.
Does that say miserably?
What does that say?
Measurably.
God dang it.
Okay.
Let me see.
Wait, who is your English teacher? Because Abby, apparently you can't read.
Measurably.
Yeah, it says measurably.
That's crazy.
Holy cow. Mr. Duell, if you're listening, we apologize. I mean, we apologize. Oh my gosh. All right. Anyway, how about you? No. All right, Abby, try again. Use your words, honey.
Maybe sound
listening to this. Do teachers exaggerate when they say high school will be measurably harder?
Yay!
Is measurably like significantly harder?
Yeah, like you're going from eighth grade, and I think they're pretty challenged. And I mean, obviously, middle school to me, they have to keep up with a lot of stuff, and they have extracurricular things. But do you think it's like a huge jump from eighth to high school?
I don't. It really depends on how much you do. Like, if you just slacked off throughout middle school, yeah, high school will suck. But if you like keep up with your work and you show that you're committed. You also do clubs and all that. I don't think the gap is as big. Now, of course, it'll still be kind of a jump. However, it's not going to be as big depending on your work ethic and like your ethos throughout middle school.
That totally makes sense. So it depends on the person.
It depends.
If you have good work habits in eighth grade, most likely that'll translate to high school.
That's it'll true. Still be right? kind of a jump. But it won't be as significant unless you like procrastinate.
Yeah. You're a good example because you guys all had good work ethics and you were busy with clubs and you did my announcements, whatever. So that's good advice. All right. Thanks, Abby. Thanks for that English lesson.
All of you, how long do you have like passing periods? Like how long is passing period?
5 minutes.
Five minutes.
Yeah. It's not that bad.
Wait, 5 minutes and you got to do that colored system?
Whatever. Red, blue, green.
Oh my God.
Like your first week, you get a pass. For freshmen, you get to like show up. Don't show up late. But you, if you don't know where you're at, they're like, oh, it's a freshman. We get it. And also for your first day of high school, like at Independence, the Link Crew take over and like help you and show you around if you need help. Like, well, like, oh, this is a science Billy. Wow. You know, but at the same time, you only get 5 minutes after the first 2 1-weeks. And then after that, like you have to just zoom. Like if sometimes the PE is all the way at the top and you have theater, so you just have to run, book
yeah.
it.
Yeah, my
Don't
first.
Fall, Abby.
All right. Real quick, to answer Jody's question, what the color system is. So basically, what room number do you have, Jody, for like one of your classes?
402.
Yeah, so, yeah. Essentially, the color system is just that. Like let's say like your English class is like B4 or something like that. It, like there's a whole like chunk of, hold on, real quick, let me explain. So like above, like floor ground, that's just like the, let's say mainly cafeteria, but there's also some classes there. But in like downstairs, that's where all the classes are. I forgot there's a downstairs. Yeah, there's like each like section is a different color, red, blue, and gray, right? And like basically, it's just another way of like saying what room number it is.
Oh.
Or some, I don't know why they did. And like another thing is, there's also rooms that are just numbers too.
Yeah.
Like they're just 101, 10. It's weird. I don't know.
Yeah, they're hidden too. So like if you get lunch detention,
I know,
then
dude.
You're just like, where's 209? And nobody shows you.
Don't forget about the yellow hallway, guys.
Yellow? There's no yellow hallway.
Just to clarify, if you're going to Independence, that's a myth.
You can't
There's
do that
only
to me.
Three hallways.
Yeah.
But don't forget, we do have a swimming pool.
Yeah, we have a swimming pool.
Oh, yeah, we do.
That's why we have a swimming pool.
We have a swimming pool on top of the roof.
Yeah, that's where a swim team
on the roof?
No.
That's where a swim team practices, guys.
My mom went to Independence. She had me on the swim for that.
Do you guys ever go at lunchtime to sunbathe and eat?
Oh, yeah, obviously. Everyone knows
you don't?
That. It's like a pool party every day. It's great. Yeah.
Okay, and then the last question that I have is, how difficult is it for you to make new friends in high school, like as introvert?
Okay. I can answer that question. Okay, as an introvert, because I it tends to...
Floor, you were an introvert.
Yes, I was. Anyways, let's ignore him. As an introvert, it's really, really hard to make friends. But once, just find one thing that you have in common with someone. Like, try, if you have multiple classes with someone that you went to school with, like already previously, try to be friends with them. Go with their friends. Try to expand slowly. But also at the same time, with your previous friends, just know you're not always gonna stay friends with them, and it's okay. And also with new friends, please avoid the drama. Freshmen always have so much drama. It's so crazy.
It's like eighth grade right now.
I know. Look, right now in eighth grade, doesn't matter. When you go into high school, it's a whole new start, new person, but you are, okay? Nobody knows you. Just go and start.
To talk with some slang. Yeah, your eighth grade street cred. Yeah, that's gonna be gone when you hit freshman year. Like at the dances, and you think you're all cool because you're doing mosh pits and stuff at the school dances, and then you're like, when you get in that dance circle, you're gonna like start hardwiring. You're gonna freak out, and then you're gonna start hitting all them Fortnite dances.
Oh, no. That's a classic. Okay. Really quick though, I think like what Floor brought up with like how you're not gonna be friends with like the old friends you used to have in elementary. I wanna like middle school, whatever. I wanna really quick add, like, if you don't have a lot of classes or like share, like see your friends a lot in like high school, don't sweat it too much, you know.
Yeah.
Like don't worry about that aspect too much, you know. You could always like try to see them like after school. You can always arrange plans, right? Don't think it's game over if you don't see your friends a lot during the school day, right?
Yeah.
That's a little piece of advice out there. That's pretty important.
Because I have a friend that doesn't go to the same high school as me. I have like three friends that don't. And we all like collectively agree to meet up and everything. So if you just make plans and try to keep that connection going, it has to be both sides. It can't just be you. If it's just you, just leave it. But at the same time, if they're both are like, oh yeah, let's meet in this day, then it's going to work. Just communicate.
Abby, do you have another question?
Do you guys get prom?
Yes.
Juniors, seniors, yes.
Yes.
Freshmen, sophomores,
you
no.
have to, if you're
wait, perfect. You wait. Has high school changed? Because I mean, I remember bringing like a freshman to.
Okay, what grade were you?
No comment.
Okay. That's the thing.
No.
My junior year, I went with a junior, but my senior year, I went with a freshman.
Okay.
I'm just saying, I did.
We're getting
all right,
out of here.
I did, but. They don't allow that anymore?
No,
I don't know.
Okay.
It's unethical.
Okay.
Hey, watch it.
Okay, so if you're 18 and then senior, a guy senior, you can't invite a female. That's the rules. But if you're a junior and a senior, you can invite. If you're under 18, you can invite freshman and sophomore to the dance. But it's like they're not invited. So you can invite them. No one will care or say anything. It's just that. It's for juniors and seniors.
They're not supposed to be there.
Yeah. They're not going to kick you out. They're not going to be like, she's a freshman. Get her.
Get her.
Yeah. They're just going to be like, oh, they brought a freshman.
There's also some dances that let you bring people from outside of Independence, right?
Yeah, but you
have to fill out.
Yeah, and you get like a form sign. I remember this hearing it on the news. Yeah.
You can, if they're 18, you can invite them too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Or wasn't it 19? Oh, something like that.
I don't even know.
If they're an old teenager, you can't.
That sounded weird. Let me try it again. All right. My two eighth grade podcasters, do you have any more questions while they're here?
Do freshmen get picked on?
This is your chance. Her question was, since she wasn't on the mic, do freshmen get picked? By the way, do they still haze? You guys know what hazing is?
Oh, yeah. Hazing. Yeah, I know.
So is it in good fun or is
it? Yeah, I think it is in good fun.
No.
Buddy
boy, no.
I guess I haven't experienced it firsthand then. I don't know.
Did anything happen to you, Floor, when you were?
No, I stood my ground.
Oh, good for you.
As a sophomore, after becoming a freshman, there's so much hatred towards freshmen. Because if you look at the way they act, they are so immature. And that's because everyone knows that. And everybody hates freshmen. Hates, quote unquote. It's because they're so immature, or like they don't care, or they think they're cool because I'm a high school. Like, we're gonna, like, other upperclassmen are gonna put you in
your place.
Yeah, upperclassmen are gonna put you in your place if you're gonna think like that. Like, not in a
good,
yeah.
No, I think that's good. I think some of these kids need that.
Yeah.
I mean, 100%.
Yeah, to kind of add on to what Floor said, when I say I have this kid is great. I'm not going to say any names.
Good, thank you.
But this kid really does rub me the wrong way a lot. And, like, it's in the words of probably my favorite teacher, my A-push teacher, they're straight from middle school. And they're going to carry that ethos with them until, like, they get put in their place. It's going to suck, but, like, if you let go of that mindset, because middle school and high school, they're basically two separate worlds.
Yeah, agreed.
Like, basically, what happens when you enter high school, like, some stuff transfers over, but a lot of, like, the social aspects, the drama, you know, hierarchies, all that stuff, it's gone.
It's gone.
It's gone completely. Because high school, it's a whole different ballpark.
And I like the idea that you guys can start to make new friends, like you said. Like, just, exactly. I mean, some of these people just, I'm like, you're going to go to high school. You may still have some friends, but you're going to meet a lot of new people and a lot of people that you have in common with. So
yeah, don't stay in a bubble.
Yeah, and that's what I always said. Don't spread yourself. I mean, I was into sports, but I hung out with pretty much any kind of group. It didn't really matter.
I say if you want to create new friends, definitely join anything, because everyone, there's going to be one person that's going to talk to you, or you're going to talk to one person because connections, you know? So just join stuff if you don't want to be lonely.
Yeah, no.
In high school, there's a lot of different, like, clubs people can join, and a lot of people, they're going to be you're going to share a common thing, like engineering club people. Mm-hmm. They want to be engineers and all that. Or what else? Swimmers, they like swim, or esports, because we have an esports team.
Yeah, are you serious?
They do.
That's really
like
cool.
Like Smash Bros, Valorant, Rocket League.
That's cool.
League. And join clubs, because you're going to find a lot of common ground.
Are the clubs after school, or is it part? Yeah, is it
really depends. Like, I know some groups, like, I know NHS and AP Social Studies, they meet sometimes before school. Gardening club as well, I know, also does that.
Wow.
But a lot of the times, there's going to be a lot of club. Culture Club, for example.
That's a band.
Oh. Culture Club.
Culture Club. Do you really want to hurt me? You guys obviously don't.
You don't know what I'm talking about. Both would get along.
No. Yeah? Do I sound like that?
Yeah.
Well, it is really great.
See?
Mm-hmm. All right, guys. I think we did it. I think this made me feel so happy to have you guys in. And your answers were amazing. So I'm really hoping, as you know, we grow, people start listening, because this one is definitely valuable to our middle school, especially eighth graders. But I really enjoyed the time, you guys, and sacrificing a Friday. So great.
I wasn't going to do anything anyway. Well,
you probably have to get caught up in your work. Sounds like you guys. Didn't you go to an all-day, like, camp or whatever the other couple weeks?
Yeah, I went to
Unitown. All day. Was that Sunday?
That was Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then Monday.
So again, time management. Yeah. I mean, you're going to get involved in those things, but you got to manage that time. Holy cow. That's crazy.
Also,
Go ahead.
Side note, if you're going to Independence and you get invited to do Unitown, do it.
Any town
too.
I will be an advisor, guys.
I want to try and become, but if like that's at least from me, do Anytown or Unitown if you get nominated.
It's definitely
110% great. Worth it.
Okay, here's the thing. Freshman boys are going to be like, I thought it was about sports. Okay, don't pay attention to him. It's freshman boys. But if you get invited, definitely do it. It's a really great experience.
Awesome. Well, those are some great outlets for our kids. Guys, next year, I think I'm going to ask you to come back. You have an open invitation anytime. Oh, yeah. But next year, since you two will be seniors and you'll be an upperclassman finally, I would love to have you guys come back in and check back in. See if anything's changed, too. Yeah. Because, I mean, this advice is good every year. So I really appreciate it. Thanks for coming in. All right, guys. We'll see you later. Yeah. I fell into